You turn on the tap, open a bottle, and start drinking. But do you know anything about this water? What if there are hidden dangers in your water that you actually cannot see? I absolutely love water, and I drink a lot of it. More than 4 liters every day. I don't drink much else than water. No sodas, no alcohol or soft drinks. But I just found out something about the water we're drinking. And to be honest, it's pretty concerning.
Painkillers, blood thinners, and chemotherapy drugs are just some of the substances that are found in your drinking water.
It turns out that finding high-quality water is extremely difficult, and most of the water we drink has negative health impacts on our bodies. So, I want to learn more about the water I drink. I plan to test various water sources to find the healthiest option for me. And I'm planning to drink all of them during my normal daily routine. I'm working, going to train, and meeting friends. Over the past few months, I've traveled from Europe to Japan, was in South America, and currently I'm living in Thailand. And when I arrive, I always ask the same question. Excuse me, can I drink the tap water here? And in most places around the world, the answer is no. That's because the water treatment facilities are not able to filter everything out of the water. But at least they try by adding a bunch of chemicals. So here in Thailand, you are definitely able to smell and taste those chemicals. But not only in places where it's obvious to not drink the tap water, even in more developed places around the world, you have a similar issue.
Much if not all tap water contains things that are bad for the biology of our cells.
The main concern is that hormones and medical compounds can't be filtered out of the water.
Some of the drug comes in us and through us and out of us totally unchanged. So we actually have active drugs going into the waterway.
Since I want to start drinking healthier water, it's pretty clear that I can't drink tap water, especially in Thailand. So I need to find an alternative. First, I'm gonna try the purest water on earth, distilled water. So my mission now will be to find distilled water. I don't know where to find it, but I'm gonna figure out. Do you have distilled water?
Water.
Distilled?
No, I have.
Do you have distilled water? She appointed me to a place where I could find it. Distilled water?
Namklan o.
Ah, yeah? This? To be honest, it doesn't look healthy at all. I'm paying for it at a petrol station. This doesn't smell healthy, doesn't look healthy, but supposedly it's healthy. Distilled water is pure H2O, which means that it is free of viruses, bacteria, and any pharmaceutical drugs. Distilled water is done by boiling water and then taking the steam and putting it into a separate container. And the outcome then is distilled water. The same process produces rain. Natural rainwater doesn't have any contaminants, but also no minerals. Well, but my version doesn't look natural at all. So to make sure that I won't die, I'm gonna give it to my friend first. You probably know him if you followed me on my channel. I have some new water. I want you to try this.
It looks like some cleaning liquid or something. It actually looks like cleaning liquid. Who buys water like this, man? What the fuck? What water pours like this? This is like the worst you can find. Smells like nothing. Underwhelming.
So this is distilled water, which I actually bought at a petrol station.
Are you sure it's distilled water? Were you able to read that up here?
So yeah, that's what I'm gonna be drinking today. So I started drinking the distilled water throughout my day. It just tastes very soft. Other than that, it tastes like water. This softness comes from the purity of the water. Not only all of the heavy metals or estrogenic compounds are being removed, but also any minerals and electrolytes. That's why when you only drink distilled water, this can have an impact on your body. So I've been drinking the water all day long, and I already drank like 3 liters or something. And it tastes good, but the weird thing is that I don't really feel hydrated. Drinking water doesn't automatically hydrate you, especially when you drink a lot of it. Electrolytes such as sodium, potassium, and magnesium are released from your body during the day. If you only drink distilled water, you may need to replenish your electrolytes.
Especially when you're sweating, all of those minerals leave your body. And therefore, you need to make sure that you put those minerals into the distilled water. I use some electrolytes for this one.
If you don't add electrolytes, this can lead to a variety of symptoms. And some of them I started to feel myself.
I found out that we need to add something to the distilled water, which are electrolytes.
Okay.
Because otherwise it's like me. I have been drinking distilled water all day and yeah. I'm very drained and tired.
Yeah, you are?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Did a lot of sports.
Ooh.
Did you buy the electrolytes also at the petrol station?
That's right.
Let's try. Tastes like a hangover drink.
Doesn't taste that great.
Like it's doable to drink it every now and then, but just like not all the time.
That's definitely not the way I would want my water to taste, so I guess I need to find another solution tomorrow.
So how can you get electrolytes naturally? Today I want to find another solution. I want to find a natural solution to the electrolyte problem, because if I'm drinking that much, I need to find a way to naturally get those electrolytes back into the body. There is one very, very natural water source which is full of electrolytes and minerals.
Do you have coconut?
Cocoa water is one of the healthiest waters you can drink.
Don't tell Nick that I drank from his coconut.
Today is a day where we're gonna only drink coconut water.
This is the natural version of what I've been drinking yesterday. Potassium, sodium and magnesium. You get all of it untouched by any industrial process and without any artificial sweeteners.
Honestly, coconut water just has the best taste. Fruity, refreshing.
And it has minerals, that's important. The only thing that I'm a little bit skeptical of is I'm done already. So I don't know how many coconuts I need today to be hydrated.
The only way to see if coconuts hydrate me better than distilled water is to drink it during my training.
So I got a fresh coconut water for the gym.
Let's see how it is to work out with some cocoa water. I need water. During my workout, I could really feel the difference of drinking water with a lot of electrolytes. Way more hydrating than the distilled water yesterday. So the workout is done, and I gotta say, I didn't drink as much as normally. Normally, I drink 1.5 liters, and this is probably 300 to 400 milliliters. But I'm not thirsty. It's actually astonishing. So this is hydrating pretty good.
It was no problem at all to drink cocoa water throughout the whole day.
So I'm home now and I gotta prepare the last water before going to sleep. So that's the coconut I'm gonna drink. I still love it. The only problem with those coconuts are that it's super unpractical to always have a coconut and a machete with you. And therefore, I would say this is not a solution which is sustainable for everywhere and for any time. So tomorrow I'm gonna find another solution which is a little bit more practical. So we gotta find an easier solution than the coconuts. That's what I'm trying to do today. And a easy workaround is, of course, bottled water. But with bottled water, there are also some nuances, because I've been drinking from plastic bottles. And plastic bottles apparently are not healthy at all.
A new study has people alarmed about the safety of plastic bottled water.
Say an average liter of bottled water contains nearly 250,000 particles of nanoplastics.
That's up to 100 times more than previous estimates. And those plastics could be linked to a whole range of health problems.
You might have heard of BPA. Plastic is not biodegradable, but it is photodegradable. This means that when plastic stands for a long time in the sun, it can break down into smaller pieces and release BPA, which is contained in plastic.
So here in Thailand, the water stands mostly outside of the supermarkets. And as you can see, it's totally in the sun. That's not the healthiest place to store those plastic bottles.
When plastic photodegrades, you're basically drinking estrogen water. And the Dr. Ken Berry explains why this can be so detrimental for your health.
If you've got these plastics in your system, is they either partially or completely engage with your estrogen receptors, which are all over your body. And that can lead to weight gain, that can lead to type 2 diabetes, that can lead to increased cancer risk. It can lead to all kinds of different things. And so you have to avoid plastic.
So after finding out about all of this, of course I don't want to drink from plastic bottles anymore. Nope. We're gonna try to find some glass water bottles on the island now. So I'm in a supermarket and it seems that everything is plastic, to be honest. Probiotic water, energy water, vitamin water. Everything is plastic.
You have water in glass bottle?
I've never seen before glass.
No?
No.
No glass bottles in sight. Today, a lot of people know how bad BPA is for our body.
And there was a huge move to ban BPA, and that move has pretty much been effective. The problem is the replacements for BPA, like BPS, look to be just as dangerous as what they replaced. Plastic is plastic is plastic.
It seems you can't find glass bottles on this island. It's crazy.
A glass bottle.
Yeah. Only soda? Yeah. So ask the shop owner if they have anything in glass bottles. And the only water they have in glass bottles is soda water.
Some people claim that this carbonated water has a lot of health benefits. But when researching about it, there is no objective evidence which can be found about that.
It's so sparkly.
Researchers have not been able to reproduce the positive effects that people have been reporting, such as improved digestion and increased energy during exercise.
So today for the training I have some sparkling water, and I gotta say, it's the least thing which I want to drink right now. You can't drink it properly. First of all, I can't swallow it.
That's what she said!
And second of all, it bloats the whole body. So this is definitely not for working out.
For people who want to transition from sugary sparkling drinks to drinking water, carbonated water is the perfect solution. I simply don't like how it tastes during the workout, so I still need to find some normal mineral water in a glass bottle.
I'm so desperate that I now got into a liquor store to ask, maybe they have it. Do you have water in glass bottles?
Ooh.
It seems like I found something. We made it. Finally found some glass water. Let's go. After hours of searching, I was finally successful. I found some water in glass.
Glass bottles do not leach harmful chemicals into your water, and you also avoid any microplastics.
Whereas with plastic bottles, no matter how high quality the water is, once it is delivered in a plastic bottle, all the health benefits are basically gone. So today I'm training with glass bottles. Gotta say, it tastes better than a plastic bottle, but from the hydration, it's pretty much the same than normal water, I would say.
Although the water I'm drinking out of the glass bottle is way better, the difference is not really noticeable. Plastic bottled water doesn't taste worse or smell bad, and all of the impurities and microplastics are invisible. And that's why most people don't really care about their water quality. While in many countries it's common knowledge that you shouldn't drink the tap water, there's still one thing we need to talk about.
When drinking bad water, our body is able to filter some of the bad stuff out. Of course, it's not ideal since it's still in our system. But if we shower in bad water, that's a bigger problem because our skin absorbs all of the contaminants like chlorine.
This is ordinary tap water. Drop 5 drops in there. If it turns yellow, there's chlorine in there.
Instantly.
Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna swish my fingers around in this one a little bit to simulate taking a bath or a shower. Drop the same number of drops in the same water.
I don't see anything. So you're telling me that in the 2 seconds you had your fingers in that water, where did it go?
Every bit of that chlorine was absorbed through my skin and now it's going into my bloodstream.
I gotta say, I find it crazy how fast those contaminants can enter your system by simply showering or bathing in this water.
Even though I tried to get the best water and avoid all the bad stuff, it seems like my efforts didn't really work. Do I really need to stop taking showers now? I'm so deep down the rabbit hole that everything related to water seems to be killing me. And at the bottom of the water rabbit hole, you find this guy.
I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay!
So I'm really wondering what the best way forward here is for me. There is a solution to the tap water problem, which is to install a reverse osmosis filter in your home.
These filters can remove the majority of contaminants we talked about in this video. Since I'm traveling so much, this is not a solution for me. So now I try to increase the quality of the water step by step, and I actually found a lot of different options. Water from Spain, sparkling water from Italy, glass bottles from France, and even water which is a melted iceberg. So during this journey, I've discovered that switching from unhealthy water to healthy water is easier than I thought. It just requires some initial time investment. With this video, now I see how important hydration really is and how to properly do it. I got my small water bottles when I'm on the road or going somewhere. I found distilled water, which is not delivered in plastic bottles. And after each workout, I'm making sure to replenish my electrolytes with some fresh coconuts. I'm less thirsty throughout the day by ensuring to get enough minerals and electrolytes. And I'm also avoiding plastic bottles as much as possible. You might be living in an area where the water quality is totally fine or even superb to drink, but I want you to make sure and research about it. Simply search for your location combined with water quality. You will find a lot of information. I find it astonishing that even with something as healthy as water, we arrived in a state of our modern society where you need to be careful about what you drink and where it comes from. Today, a healthy life requires extra effort. For every sip of water, you have a choice. So ask yourself, which water do you choose to drink? Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm an independent filmmaker and therefore finance everything I do through donations. So, if you want to help me make more videos like these, feel free to send me some Bitcoin, or you can find some other payment links down in the description. Other than that, a subscribe or a like helps me immensely. And if you want to connect with like-minded people who care about their health, we also have a Telegram group where we talk about all different topics. So feel free to join there as well. Other than that, I'm gonna see you in the next video. Bye bye.